Hello, you are welcome back to my channel and thanks for stopping by. So today we'll be making a giant rose. This rose, you can use it to design your blouse, your gown, your skirts. We'll be making use of this doll face fabric as a base. Let's say this is your main fabric you are working with. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to fold it into four. So because this is a tutorial, I'll just work with a little circle. So I'm working with a circle of 5 inches. So from the tip here, I'll take my 5 inches round. So this is what I have. So we are assuming that this is your main fabric. It depends on the location you want your rose to be. So with this tutorial or this cutting, you know where your rose should fall. If you are working with your main fabric, you are not going to cut your main fabric. Let's say this is the center of your blouse. You know where to fold to get the midpoint. You know where to fold. I'm going to mark the midpoint. I'm going to locate the middle. So this is my midpoint here. And I'm working with this organza fabric. So I'm going to fold my fabric. Then I'll fold again. Because I don't want to waste time in cutting it. So the measurement depends on how long you want your rose to be. If you want your rose to be 2 inches after sewing it, it means that you are going to cut 4 inches, 4 inches, so that when after folding it, you have your 2 inches. But if you want your rose to be about 3 inches, you are going to cut out 6 inches, so that after folding, you have your 3 inches. I'll be working with 5 inches because I want my rose to be about around 2.5 inches after sewing. So from here, I'll measure 5 inches. I'll measure another 5 inches. So I'll cut it once. So this is for the sake of the tutorial. I don't want to cut too much fabric. Let me trim the edges here. So I'm going to join the organza together to have a long strip. I'm going to make a spiral effect here. So here is the midpoint. So I'm going to continue doing this. I'm going to fold my fabric into two, pin them together. Make sure you have an equal edge. From the beginning there, I'm going to mark 10 inches. There's my 10 inches. So I'm going to draw a line like this. a slanted line till I get to the edge. This is what I have. So I'm going to cut out. I'm going to use my hand to make a little rose till I get to where our 2.5 inches started. So to start with, always make sure you have an equal edge. So this is folded into two. I'm going to begin with, I fold this way, slanted it like this. Then I'll start making a turn. Always make sure your edge are equal. So I'm turning it round till I get to where my 2.5 inches started. Making the edge equal is very important, please. So that is what I'll keep doing. This is where our 2.5 inches stops. So I'm going to sew here. I'm going to sew them together. So I sewed and backstitched the little rows here and trim out the excess. So to sew the little rows to our main fabric, we are going to place this part I sew to the midpoint here like this and sew. So I've stitched our little rows to the main fabric here. So I'm going to start turning my organza round. So you start sewing and make sure the edges are equal before sewing. So we'll start following that spiral line. But that spiral line is just a guide as a beginner. You can just be going close to the already sewn organza. So we'll be going round, 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 round. Okay? But the most important thing, make sure your organza is equal. Make sure the edges are equal. If you want it to be really full, you can be pleating it while sewing. You can be pleating it little by little while sewing. But I'm not going to be pleating it for the sake of the video. Just follow the lines I just created, but that is not really necessary. But as a beginner, it's just a guide. You can just be sewing close to the already sewn ones. This is what I have. I just wish I sewed this rose on the main fabric. Let's say this is your main fabric and you are making use of lining. You are going to attach your rose first, then you use your lining to close it up, to turn it. You can use this to design your blouse, your skirt, your sleeve, and your gown. You can use it to design anything. Are you seeing? So just be sewing it round and very close to the other so that you have a full rose. You can see, if you look closely at my own, there are some parts that are empty. So just be sewing close to the other so that you have a full rose, okay? So tell me what you think about this rose. What will you use it to design? For me, I will use it to design a sleeve. See you in my next video. Please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to share, subscribe, and comment. Thank you.